Like that, could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
That was all Preston Smith navigating into the backfield. He gets the tackle for loss.
As a linebacker, you're taught to stay just slightly behind the ball carrier just in case he makes a cutback. But when you find the gap, shoot it. And he found it all right. Took it straight into the backfield and made the tackle for a loss.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. So it's a gain of 12 there on the reception. And that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call a no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. They'll try and run for it. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. They fake the give. Now Garoppolo looks to throw. And that one off the mark behind him. Incomplete. He was trying to get it to George Kittle, his tight end. And that'll bring up second down. And Charles, despite this list of key inactives that we see here, they've obviously still been pretty successful.
Give everyone credit for this one, because to me, when that happens, key guys are out, the next man steps up and plays well. But that starts with the organization itself, all the way through. No excuses for guys being out. Finding guys who are capable backups who can step up and play when they need them. And we've seen the results of that. This team knows how to work through things.
Garoppolo gonna try and throw on third. This one caught by Kittle. Touchdown, 49ers. George Kittle, 43 yards. And the Niners are on the board first here in this division round matchup. Forget about the storylines of being intimidated in the playoffs on the road. I mean, that was pretty clinical right there.
Yeah, they didn't treat it like it was a playoff game in January, did they?
No.
That felt much more like, hey, we're back in August, running a few drills in the practice field. They seem unaffected by what they're facing in this one.
Gold with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. Rodgers on the return. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their own 23. Throwing to start the drive. Rodgers, and his throw is incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones, takes this to the 27, give him 4 yards.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down, because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Completes it left side to the tight end, Lewis. And he'll be brought down at the 28, and that is well short of the first. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down.
There's an example of good situational football being played by a defense. They understood where the third down play was, the down and distance, and made sure that they didn't get anywhere near that, bringing up fourth down.
Yeah, they were sniffing out that marker, didn't want to let him get close to there, and now a likely 3 and out to start.
Yeah, I love the way they rallied to the football and got to him and made sure he didn't give up much run after catch.
A pretty good punt there, but also a nice return of 12 yards. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. Back out there comes the 49ers offense, ready for their second drive. And they'll be looking to make this a two-score advantage. Had the touchdown on their first drive, Charles. Hey, they can get up 2 scores here on the road. That's a heck of a start.
And not only have they thought about it, I wonder if they visualized it. I remember playing, and they used to turn the lights out in our meeting room and run through a situation like this and say, just think about what it would be like to be up on the road and take the crowd out of it. Maybe they did some of that.
A little too much extracurricular there.
When you have a game with a lot of contact, tensions are going to run pretty high. You're going to be emotional, but you have to harness it somehow, and he didn't on that play.
And he's got this down to the 35. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off. And I feel a little bit like a traitor as a former defender because that big man did not want to go down and refuse to go down. If you're a defender and you don't get the right angle on a big tight end like him, he can run right through you like you're not even there. And he did a lot of that on that play.
Inside the red zone, it's Garoppolo. This is Jennings. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass on the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Elijah Mitchell, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the 49ers are off to a 13-0 first quarter lead.
It's not much as perfect in football, but that's about as close to it as you're going to get. Score, force a punt, score again.
And both drives were impressive. The opening drive was, that last one was. Now on the other side, though, what's your psyche? You're really behind the eight ball. It's Rodgers, and his throw's going to be incomplete.
And let's face it, this defense has had its share of struggles all game long, and they know that they can put it all behind them if they defend well here in the 2-minute drill. Excellent coverage right there to force the incompletion.
On second down, it's Jones, and the ball is out. Jones got hit and lost it, and now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line.
So now, I think even our referee is confused. The defense accepted the holding penalty, but they just got the ball on the fumble recovery, so that will be negated. That's a tough one to comprehend.
Meanwhile, Rodgers' throw here pulled in by Lazard. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Call it a gain of 12, but of course not a first down due to the previous penalty. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this play. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked by Emmanuel Mosley. And into the end zone. A pick six for the 49ers. They score the touchdown. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
The Niners will continue on as we say so long, everybody.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Day.